Good morning. Hello. Hey, sweet girl. Oh, your mouth's all wet. Hey. Hello. Good morning. Come here. Crazies. Good morning. Come on. Bye. Oh. Oh. Not happy. Go play. Great day at school. Okay. Say bye to the vlog. You gonna have a great day?
Yeah.
I love you.
It's cold.
It's not that bad.
You're wearing a sweatshirt.
Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Madison. If you're new here, just being a little mom today, going through car line to drop the little one off at school. You're gonna have a great day. All right, just dropped Kinsey off. I am getting gas right now. I'm so obsessed. This is like my new like coffee obsession. It's the Rise Nitro Brew coffee. I already drank one today. This is the oat milk latte. And then this is the like oat milk mocha. But literally listen to what it sounds like when you open it. It's the little things. But yeah, these are so good. I have like an affiliate link that I will put down below. Definitely recommend. But I am headed to an appointment. I'm getting my teeth like professionally whitened today, and I'm so excited. I've been like wanting to do this for a while now. So yeah, that is what I'm doing. It's called Zoom whitening, so it's like immediate whitening. And they said like my teeth will literally be like glowing white at first, but like after about 7 days they'll be at the shade that they're like going to be, but way whiter than they are now. I mean, my teeth aren't like bad, but definitely could be whiter, so excited to get them whitened. We are done. I have like a tray in right now because they give you this relief gel because your teeth are like pretty sensitive afterwards. I literally have a lisp. But it was like so relaxing. They basically use like the whitening gel in the light to give like immediate results, and it's 4 intervals of 15 minutes, so it takes about an hour, like 2 hours total with like everything else that they do. But yeah, Like I said, it was so relaxing. The office, I mentioned a little bit about it in my vlog last week because I came for a consultation. But it's like a cosmetic dentist. And so if you're in this area and like need any sort of like whitening or cosmetic dentist services, it's the Art of Cosmetic Dentistry. And it's like Dr. Morgan. But yeah, the office is so fancy. The chair massaged me. I was watching HGTV the whole time. Like, it was seriously amazing. But yeah, I mentioned also in that vlog that I have like some white spots in my two front teeth. It's, I forgot what it's called, but it's basically caused from whenever I had braces when I was younger. A lot of people have it. But I was gonna do like the whitening and then do the microabrasion to kind of remove those white spots. But honestly, now that my teeth are whiter, it like blends better. And they also give you like these trays and then like at home whitening stuff. So that way, like after doing this, if you still haven't reached your like desired whiteness, and then you can like keep doing it. They recommend like waiting 7 days after having this done, and then if you want to keep doing it, do like the at-home whitening. So I'm just gonna like wait and see like what I want to do, but I feel like once I get them whiter, it like you won't even really see the white spots. So I feel like I won't really need to spend the money on the microabrasion, but like I said, we'll see. So yeah, very happy with how they turned out. And I will like show you guys whenever I get home and can like take out the trays, like what they actually look like. So just picked this guy up from the vet. Hello. Why you look so sad? We thought he had like a urinary infection because he was like sporadically like peeing just everywhere. But nope, no infection. He was just being a pain in the ass. he's a boy, so it's to be expected. I'm so happy to have them back. We got them back on Monday from the trainer. So if you've like been following me, Willow was gone for 3 weeks and Winston was gone for 2 weeks, and they were at training, and it was like for like basic obedience, manners, just basic training cues, things like that. Obviously, we're like capable of training a dog, but with two, it's just a little more difficult. So we thought it'd be beneficial in the long run to get them trained by a professional. So that is what we did. And we're so happy with like everything that they've learned and like the progress that they've made. Obviously, we still have to like keep it up and like keep reminding them and working with them because they're not perfect. But they're definitely way better, so very happy with it, and definitely recommend getting your dog trained if that's something you can afford or want to do. If you are in Georgia, we used Full Focus Canine. They're located in Lawrenceville. They were amazing, and they seriously treated our dogs as if they were our own, and they like update you regularly with like pictures and videos and things like that, so it was really nice because obviously we miss them. But yeah, I'll like insert a clip here of like one of the one of the videos that she sent us of the two of them. It's so cute, so I'll play that here.
Down. Good.
But yeah, so cute. I love them so much. If you haven't caught on, I'm obsessed with my dogs. But do you blame me? I mean, look at him. Look at him. He's like blinded by the sun and he wants to go home. Are you ready to go home? Are you ready to go home? All right, just got home and took the trays out. So this is what they look like. Very happy with how they turned out. She even showed me these little like teeth sample shades that she had to show the difference of like where my teeth were to where they are now. And it was like drastically different. So very happy with them. Not going to lie, they hurt like a bitch right now. I keep getting like random like tingling of pain in my teeth just because they're like very sensitive. But she said that that should go away within like 24 hours. So definitely worth it, and definitely recommend doing Zoom whitening if you want your teeth whiter. Yum. Who's hungry? Who's hungry? Are we hungry? Hey, who's hungry? Is it dinner time? Okay, you guys are psychos. Stop! So I realized that today marks 3 months alcohol-free for me, which is so huge. I honestly never thought that I would stick with it, so I'm very proud of myself for like getting this far. It's honestly become like a natural thing for me. Like obviously it's been easier than it probably would be if we like weren't in quarantine, since I haven't really had like as many opportunities to like tempt myself. Like I'm not going out as much and things like that. I honestly have just been like doing my own thing, working on myself, and really like staying busy with things that like aren't tied to drinking. So that's made it a lot easier. But yeah, I'm just really proud of myself. I feel really good. I'm much happier. I don't have as much anxiety. People have said that my, like, they can notice my face, like, thinning out more. And honestly, just overall, like, thinner everywhere. I feel like alcohol definitely makes you more bloated. So it's definitely helped with my physical appearance, but mostly mental. If you didn't see my post on, like, why I stopped drinking, I just like blacked out really easily. I had really bad hangovers. My anxiety was really bad. I just like didn't like who I was when I drank. And I tried to like cut back and not drink as much, but that just like didn't work for me. I still had anxiety or ended up drinking too much, or just still feeling like shit the next day. So that just didn't work for me. So I just really like made the decision one day to stop altogether, and I'm so glad that I did. I definitely think that stopping drinking is definitely something that you have to want to do. It definitely takes like a commitment, just because there are so many things to like tempt you to break your commitment. So it's just like really like I've stuck my ground and I've gotten this far. And yeah, I get the question all the time about whether this is like something that's going to go on forever, and to be honest, I don't know. I'm just taking it day by day. I just knew that alcohol was holding me back from like becoming my best self, so I just know that until I feel like I've gotten to that good place, I'm not going to incorporate it back into my life. But maybe someday I'll get to a point where I can like have a drink on special occasions or things like that. But I definitely never want it to get like out of control again. So yeah, I'm so happy with the fact that I stopped drinking. I've grown such an obsession with sparkling water. This is the Trader Joe's blueberry lemonade flavored water. Our mini fridge is literally stocked with all of my sparkling waters. But it's just like finding alternatives and finding what works for you. I've definitely found so many things that have helped me like get through these 3 months. I am planning on like kind of sharing my like tips that have helped me on like Instagram if anyone is interested or maybe has been like wanting to stop alcohol themselves. So if anyone is interested or like wants to stop drinking, I'm always here to chat. Obviously I'm new to this, but I would love to like give any sort of encouragement or like share my experiences, because obviously I'm being very open about it. It's kind of funny because when I've like gone out, people literally are like, oh, like are you pregnant? Or oh, were you an alcoholic? It's just funny because I'm like, no, I just like decided to stop, and they just think it's like so crazy because that's so unheard of, which is so crazy to me because I feel like it should be such a normal thing because I feel like so many people can relate. Like, I know so many like close people and friends who have said themselves that they don't like blacking out, or their hangovers are really bad, or they make mistakes, or just don't like who they are when they drink. But I just think that people don't ever realize that they need to stop, or that it is a problem, because it's not like, not drinking is not normalized, so they don't want to like be looked at as like a loser or not have friends because they don't drink. But truly, I feel like it's honestly helped me determine who my real friends are, and the ones who are capable of like doing fun things that aren't always alcohol related or don't make me feel guilty when I'm around because everyone is drinking and I'm not. It's also been like a real challenge for me in social settings because I can be a very like laid back, like quiet person. So not drinking has really like challenged me to open up and be more myself, and not rely so heavily on alcohol to like make me fun. So that's definitely something that I've been working on, and I think that's like a huge thing. But yeah, I just think that like, if you want to stop drinking, like don't let the fear of like what other people are gonna think hold you back. So take that as my advice, and cheers to 3 months alcohol free.